YouTube. So today I've got no intro for you guys. I'm just going to dive right into the topic. The topic of today is semen retention will have you caring less about what other people think of you. Now, I'm aware, and you are also aware, that 90% of our lives we stay thinking about what every other person around us thinks about us. Even people far away from us, people we speak with on the phone, people we text every day, we tend to think about what these people think about us constantly. Now, when you get on semen retention, what semen retention is going to do to you is, it's going to make you full in yourself, it's going to make you whole. It's going to complete, it's going to bring, because, you know, you fought the urges of releasing, and in fighting those urges, you are bringing the darkest, deepest side of yourself out, and you are healing that part of yourself. That part of yourself that would go out and look for validation and compliments for people to feel whole, to feel full, to feel really okay, that part is going to be healed. Now, why do I say that? When you get on this journey, your body, your mind, and your spirit all align. You become self-actualized. Other people will say enlightened. When you go on a very long streak, you are going to become self-actualized. You are going to realize the self. And in realizing the self, you realize that there is no need, that there's nothing outside of you that has power over you. Be it compliments, be it people's negative reactions, be it negative comments, be it... You just stop caring less. And in caring less, every other person starts caring about you. Because... why are you not looking for my validation? And trust me, people can feel it. People can feel that this person does not give a shit. It's not like you don't give a shit from an ego point of view. It's more like you no longer care about anything outside. Everything outside becomes secondary. Because semen retention on its own is an inward journey. So everything outside of you becomes secondary. You focus on how you are feeling in every particular moment. Sometimes I'll be in the gym and I totally forget that there are people around me, and I'm singing out loud and I'm dancing, and then I realize, oh shit, I'm in the gym. But then I'm like, okay, what should I be doing? Like, why do I think that this other person's opinion of me in this moment is important? I always ask myself that when I catch myself dancing and, you know, speaking out loud in the gym. I'm like, why? Because my gym is a very small gym, you know, and it's I'm in the gym with Germans, and you know how Germans are, and they are quite monotonic, you know. I don't think they know how to have fun per se, you know, like everybody's so serious and nah, that's not me. So I dance, and then when I catch myself, I'm like, I ask myself that question, like, why in this moment should I care about what this person thinks of me? Like, because I understand from self-realization, you're going to understand the fact that everybody's still figuring it out. Every person you meet does not know what they are doing. When I say they do not know what they are doing, I mean life is about uncertainty. Like there's nobody certain of anything, you know, like everybody's figuring it out. So there's no need to be pleasing any other person. Like, because that person you're trying to please is also figuring it out. The reason why you're trying to please that person is because you see that person right now is at a level where you are not, maybe, or just simply for the fact that you do not feel whole in yourself. You know, you don't know who you are, so you tend to seek validation from others. But on this journey is going to teach you, this journey is going to show you who you are, because you will die. you overcoming those urges is slowly killing you, slowly killing that self, that lower self, you know. And now that energy is rising, rising. And when it gets to a certain point, I think your heart chakra, you start to, how do I say it? You would just walk up to a total stranger, man, and you'd be like, hi, like, what's good? You walk up to total strangers. Like, you no longer fear walking up to people. You no longer fear rejection. Because, bro, you are solidified. Any trouble, any problem, you are fit for it, you know. Similar intention makes you fit for it. You become fearless. There's this boldness. There's this drunken courageousness you have, you know. And another thing is, you're always in this alpha state, alpha frequency, you know. You are always calm, you are, you're just going with the flow, you know. Like, you now understand that everything comes and goes, you know, because you did not give in to the urges. You've seen the nature of desires, you've seen the nature of things, you've seen that they are all fleeting, they come and go. Do you understand? Those who do not understand the fact that things come and go are those that you find that are still struggling with life, you know. There's a term for it, they call it 3D, you know. They are so affected by the things happening around them, like what somebody said, what da 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 da. But you on this journey, you are already ascending. So naturally, those people cannot hurt you anymore. Like, there's nothing they're going to say, that because in your head you're just like, okay, what should I do? Like, okay, what do you want me to do? Like, now you said this to me, what should I be doing, you know? Or some people personally try to ignore you just so that you care about them and their opinion, so that you see them as superior to you. And bro, well, again, like I always say, man, you have to always come from compassion, because at some point in time, you were that person, you know? You were that person you are looking at and judging, like, oh, you are so low vibrational, you are so this, you are so toxic, you are so... Just love them from afar, you know, like, don't put out that energy, don't put out the negative energy back, because then they win, you know? Like, who said it? I think Jay-Z said, seeing two people argue from afar, you would not know who the fool is. something of that sort. If you see two people argue from afar, you would not know who the fool is. And also, a fool is going to drag you down to his level and beat you, you know. You don't have the capacity. That is their reality. That is what they live in, you know. That is the frequency they are abiding in. They live in this frequency all the time, so they've mastered it. They've mastered the act of pissing people off. They've mastered the act of giving negative energy. They've mastered the art of... Now, why would you watching this video, why would you want to then go down to their level, play the game with them, and then get beaten? Then you're mad, and then they've won, and then they're happy, and then they've taken your energy, and then you're there mad. You're just looking at them like, hi. You're just looking at them like, okay, now what, like, okay, I've matched your energy. What in their head, these people's head, they are laughing at you because they see you, they know who you are, they understand your vibration, you know, and that's why they're attacking you in the first place. So in their head, they're like, oh yeah, I got him where I want him to be now, you know. He's argued with me, he's giving me that negative energy, I've been able to spoil his day, I've been able to get him emotional to react to my bullshit. Now here, I've won. Don't react to people's bullshit, man. Just don't care. Just leave it to them. Try this. Anytime you find yourself in an uncomfortable situation, I mean there are situations where you would need to address them immediately. But if this is not a life or death, like somebody trying to control you or somebody trying to tell you what to do, bro, just say nothing. Don't do it. They are going to shout, ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. And then they find out that they have no power over this person. And then they just skididado. They just walk away. So guys, please, keep retaining on this journey. By the way, today is my day 7 of this new streak. So, let's keep going, guys. Let's keep going. I'll try, man. I'll try to post a video every day. It's hard for me because I'm still struggling with time management. I tend to use social media a lot, which at this moment I'm no longer finding it pleasing. Like, if it's not social media that is going to bring money to me, like, then I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. I'm not going to be using it. So, yeah, guys, retain your seed. Retain your seed. Retain your seed. And if you relapse, don't feel bad. Yes, some people don't. I mean, I'm not asking you to compare yourself to other people. I mean, the journey is your journey. It's you against you. You yesterday and you today. That's all that matters. But at the same time, just to make you feel good, there are other people on this journey, or in this life, I mean, who don't even have an idea of this. And they're living in that frequency, that miserable frequency. But you have the idea. Yes, you're going to fail. But you are aware of it now. It's all about you keep on going. Keep on going. Fail and go. Fail and go. I'm not telling you not to fail. Fail and go. Fail and continue. Fail and continue. And learn to love yourself through all the process of your ups and downs. You know? Because every this goes with every that. Every here goes with every there. A crest, a trough. I don't know if it's the opposite. A trough, a crest. Whichever one. But you get the point. It's always two sides to a story, you know. Accept the bad. Accept the fact that you've relapsed. Accept the fact that you do not, you were not able to be disciplined in the moment of weakness. And learn from that. Learn what made you to be in that situation in the first place. Learn what made you to be in that situation in the first place. Then, and only then, can you succeed on this journey. So guys, love yourself and do not give a shit about what people think of you. Because in the end, everybody is going to die. You, me, him, everybody is just a matter of time. At some point, you did not exist. Now you exist. At some point, you're not going to exist. So what the fuck are you so concerned about people's thoughts about you for? Please tell me. Just give me one reason right now why you live your life based on what you think people are going to like and what people are not going to like. Just give me one good reason, man. One good reason. I'm waiting. Write it in the comment section. Hey, my name, then I care about people's opinion because write it down in the comment section and let's talk about it. Because bro, I used to be that person, man. And trust me, when you stop giving a shit, they are going to call you arrogant, they are going to call you a prick, they are going to call you names, you know. It all boils down to the fact that they cannot control you, you know. They do not have any control over your emotions or you as a person. So let them be mad, let them stay mad, you know. One thing you have to understand, nobody above you, yeah, ever wants to be like you here, down here. It's always the people down here that are always envious of you here. But I mean, in this case, being in semi retention, it doesn't matter if you have money or not, because it's energy. Energy never lies, you know. Energy is the topmost currency you can have in this life, you know. So people who are poor can have a good energy and someone who is rich can have a low, very low vibrational energy. So in that sense, yes, there can be envy, but you still should not care, man, because what? Nothing is going to happen to you, bro. Nothing. You are the shit. Accept it and stop caring. Care less and your life will become better. 100 times better. Trust me. Trust me. 100 times better. 100. What? 1 million times better. What are you saying? 1 million times better, guys. So please, relax, love yourself, eat good food, drink good water, go out. If you have friends to hang out with them, read a book, do something. Just fuck people's opinion, man. In the end, it doesn't matter. Yeah? One love, guys. Love you guys. See you. And please, like, share, and subscribe. It's your boy, Chooks, and I'm out.